Welcome back to my United States of America campaign, or USA campaign, in the game, Rome Total War Barbarian Invasion, using the mod, Total Overhaul mod actually, Total War 1942. Okay, so in the past I played a German campaign in an earlier version of this mod, and now I'm playing the United States of America. This is episode 3. The mod was created by Mother Dagovax and Mother Saloth-Sar. And I helped with some stuff, but I did the least work on the mod. Most of the map, I believe, and some of the gameplay and scripts that are here by Saloth-Sar, and the rest by Dagovax. What I did was, I did 207 quotes. I did all the faction descriptions except the Spanish one, and I did some gameplay stuff too. Okay, so, and this version of the mod is a sub-mod of an older version than the one released on ModB. So it's using some changes by me that I did during a 2-week period. So this is a sub-mod. I did all the work on the sub-mod stuff. The reason I modified this version instead of the 2.0 version was because it was unstable and would crash all the time. I believe Saloth-Sar has released a fix for the 2.0 version, and I've since downloaded the new version of 2.0 with the fix, and Paris, etc. worked fine. I still have to try the campaign and see if I can actually finish a campaign in it, if I can click end turn until the end or not. It works in this version. So this is an updated version of the 1.3 version. It has all the units from the 2.0 version. It has the German settlements except Berlin, and it has some new projectiles, new animations, new effects, and changes to the map that we saw in the earlier episodes, but it doesn't have certain things from the 2.0 version, like Paris or the French cities or the Italian cities or certain other stuff. This version, of course, has the German UI too, for the factions using the German culture, such as Germany, Finland, Hungary, and Bulgaria. Okay, and possibly Romania. But anyway, we are going to continue the United States campaign. The reason I'm not playing in the 2.0 version with the fix is because I am not 100% sure that it's stable. So I will need to first try to just click end turn until the end of the campaign and see if it's stable. If it is, I will move this campaign to that version instead, because it's more fun to play on a version with Italian custom cities and French custom cities and a lot of other details that this version doesn't have. But if I'm gonna play on that version, I probably need to do some personal changes to it first, like some changes to unit stats to make sure that planes are better than tanks and tanks are better than infantry. Otherwise, it will be a mess where the infantry can take down planes and such, like in the original mod. I believe my stat changes made it more historically correct or realistic. So I would like those changes in 2.0 before playing it. And also, I believe that I maxed out all the unit sizes, but I might not do that for the 2.0 version, because while it was epic to use the maximum unit sizes on the battlefield, it didn't work well in siege battles, because they usually could crash. I had to play on large unit sizes, not huge, when using the maximum unit sizes, like in this version of the mod. So I'm playing on large and not huge, because huge, it would be impossible to move troops in cities, because they had so long lines that they didn't really react when you clicked on them to move. If the AI controlled them, they would work, but not when you try to, as the player, move them manually. So large unit size was better, but even on large, certain battles can crash, certain siege battles, because custom settlements are very demanding on the old engine, and with too many troops and the custom settlements in the same battle, the game is more likely to crash. So if I'm gonna move to the 2.0 version, I won't move over the unit size, so I will probably keep the troop numbers as they are, or give them a slight boost, but not a maxed out boost. I will probably max out the tanks, because because I like the idea of having 16 tanks instead of maybe 6 or 4 or whatever was in the original. Okay, so we'll play this episode, but we will, after we have tried 2.0, if it's stable, we will move this campaign there, and then I will move over certain stats to units, and I will also change the map, because I want South America to have more factions than just the United Nations, or League of Nations, and I also want Japan to start with the area down here that we took from the People's Republic of China, Hollandia. So I will give Hollandia to the Japan faction, to the Japanese, and I will give, I will most likely give South America to the Spanish, the Portuguese, and the Germans, so we can have some challenge there too. Otherwise it's boring as the United States when we are never attacked, you know. We might be attacked by the British, of course, but it's not enough. Here we have the Japanese. Unfortunately, this rifleman unit won't be able to join the battle. We can face off against the Japanese army. Okay. So, the problem is, so we have one unit in Hollandia and one unit outside. Can't move that unit anymore. If I reloaded the game, I could probably do it. We might actually do that now that I know where they are. Let's... fuck, I forgot that this game might not handle loads like this too well. I might need to restart the game. You'll see. In Medieval 2 I can easily load like this, but I am not sure if the scripts work now. Might fuck up my ability to save the game too. So if it doesn't work, we'll have to restart. Because I forgot that this is Rome Total War and not Medieval 2, and that there is some changes. Okay, it seems to work fine to save the game. Okay, we will try to just move this army. Bodyguard should be a part of the army. Your will, sir. We have Douglas, no, Douglas MacArthur is an important guy, so we don't want to waste him necessarily. Okay, so we have moved them there. Now we can attack with Douglas MacArthur, but we will control him manually to keep him out of harm's way. So the Japanese, we have Satsu Higashima, and we have Takashide Goto, okay, Takahide Goto, actually. Okay, let's save the game before the battle. We always need to do that in case it will crash in the battle, or after the battle, or before the battle. Okay, and we will place the allow this army to be controlled by the AI. Yeah, I think so. And let's fight the battle on the battle map. So this wasn't the battle that I had planned to fight, but we'll fight this one first and then we'll fight the other one. Of Kuala Lumpur, I believe. Capital of Malaya. Okay. Held by the Japanese. It's currently under siege by our armies. Okay, so we'll fight the Japanese here in this area first, in New Guinea, or Papua New Guinea. Okay, start deployment. okay, lose formation with the General MacArthur. He obviously doesn't have his own portrait. Let's start the battle. Send the horn. Reinforcements, Captain Paul. Directly to the reinforcements. We can see that our Boeing 17 heavy bombers are entering the battlefield. Also the planes are also maxed out, so the troops are maxed out, but this is on large unit size. So on small unit size we have 30 troops in a unit, and on medium we have 60, twice as much, twice as many. And then on large we have 120, twice as many as 60. And then on huge we have 240, twice as many as 120. And it's totally epic to use huge, but as I said, it's impossible to move troops manually in cities, so that's why I use large. And even on large, certain battles crash, certain siege battles. So I will probably not use these numbers if I move to the other version of the mod, with additional custom settlements and new religions and other stuff added by Dagovax. And some script changes added by Saloth-Sar, which forces the Axis powers to be allied each new turn. Okay, these have arrived here. Here we have their bodyguard. We have their air force, zero fighters. They could take out our bombers if we're unlucky. I believe our bombers are not as good fighting planes, I might be wrong. And they are taking down some of them, unfortunately. We have our own fighter planes. I believe the Japanese had better attack, we had better defense. We'll see which planes will rain sky. I probably would keep the size of planes and the size of tanks in 2.0, like I have it here. But the troops, the infantry would be reduced a bit. We have some Japanese soldiers marching on the ground. Moving up there, cool infantry. Samurai looking infantry. Okay. But our wing heavy bombers are bombing them on the ground, even though they are taking down some of them. Unfortunately, they are heavily bombing them, bombarding them, which is very good. The fighters seem to have won against the Japanese planes. Still have some planes in the air, but I believe we have won. Battle, maybe they've taken them out already. They had some tanks. They have more infantry. Had a lot of infantry in the battle, which isn't that surprising. But here they have tanks. As we see, I've maxed out the numbers. So there are like 16 tanks in a unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At least 12. These are the renowned Utsus of the Japanese Empire. They're better than the renowned FTs of the French Republic. Also have a bunch of Jeeps. We have some Shermans, M4 Shermans. They are obviously better than those tanks. They are medium tanks, and we have the D1 Cunningham tanks, light tanks. They are worse, most likely. Fuck, the units became a little bit bugged, maybe because I loaded the game, I forgot. I believe we hadn't been in many battles, so not many are bugged, only a few. I forgot to restore the unit size after the battle against the Chinese in Hollandia. Because the Chinese had revolted over there. Alright. It's looking good. I like what I see. So, enemy general fallen. Sachio Higashiyama of the Japanese Empire has fallen.
Our noble allies have lost their leader. Without their general, they may lose heart and flee.
Okay, the captain died of the United States, but moved to General MacArthur. He's in a safe distance away from the battle. Alright, so our tanks have finally reached the battlefield. They've already lost most of their infantry and stuff. The jeeps are retreating or wavering. Sucks that some of the tanks became without turrets. Okay, let's continue the battle. We have won the battle, now we just need to chase them out of the battlefield. So we defeated the Japanese on Papua New Guinea. They're still bombarding them. Our Boeing B-17 bombers. I believe they have taken out some of our own tanks with our own bombs, unfortunately. And we won the battle. Our infantry just managed to arrive. Alright, close victory. So Douglas MacArthur of the United States killed one in battle. Captain Paul had 533 men, he killed 768 of the Japanese, 457 remaining. Enemy forces under Satsuo Higashiyama. The Japanese Empire had 843 men, killed only 7, and 123 remaining. Takahide Goto of the Japanese Empire had 180 men, killed 15, 124 remaining. So it was a very bad result for the Japanese here. Just as the defending force has gathered valuable experience from Dipe, so has the assaulting force. He will not do it like this a second time. Field Marshal von Rundstedt, August 1942. So we're done here, we can move these troops away from here. But at the same time we have the British, they might betray us later, so we can move the troops towards Finlandia for now. We can move the tanks already all the way back. Lanes. And we do not have any other tanks or planes of the same type, so we can't merge them. But we can now attack this area. And as it's a siege battle, it's a siege battle where they have planes and tanks. I guess we will control the infantry and let this army steamroll. City, so we'll attack. We don't have any siege here. That sucks. And the infantry will be slaughtered by their planes and tanks. That sucks. Many times will I have to wait one turn? Then we'll have to wait with the attack one turn. Alright, go back to America, can see if I've moved the agents already, I probably already have moved them, we'll see. Should have a spy over here, female spy somewhere. So the League of Nations have moved out their troops, they're probably in the way, I can hardly see the agent. That sucks, we'll need to go to the menu, as I can't find it. Okay, let's see here, spy. Ah, we've already moved. Your orders, sire. We need a fleet here. Boarding ship. Okay, have I done the recruitment then? I think I have. Let's see. Yeah, we will click end turn. Candidate for adoption. No, thank you. End of turn report. Okay. Faction announcements. Okay. Construction report. So in New York we have some brick wall. Chicago we have a brick wall. In Los Angeles we have a brick wall. Palembang we have an airstrip. In Casablanca we have an airstrip. And in Hollandia we have an airstrip. Okay. Diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. Portugal and the Japanese Empire. Hungary and the Third Reich. Following factions have broken their alliances, the Third Reich and Romania. Following factions have declared their allies, Romania and Turkey. And the following factions have declared a ceasefire, Bulgaria and the British Commonwealth of Nations. Okay, recruitment report. In Washington we have a rifleman unit recruited, then we have a rifleman unit, and in Batavia we have corsairs constructed, and in area we have corsairs, okay. And now we can immediately do the recruitment and construction, I believe. We start in Boston. So we can go for a brick wall in Boston. Or actually I don't want a brick wall. We go for military buildings. So in Boston, I think what we want is the Hippodrome, which will give us better tanks and such. No, we want planes. Catapult range will give us the siege, I see. So unlike Germany, the United States do not have custom buildings yet, with the exception of the airstrip stuff. They are shared between factions, I think. We'll go for the airstrip. We'll build airstrips everywhere, or aerodromes. Aerodrome will give us the Boeing B-17. We'll go for it. Planes are the best units in the game. We need planes. Okay, stables will give us tanks. We'll go for that in Washington. We couldn't go for anything else. In Chicago, we go for the airstrip, so we get the corsairs, the fighter planes. In New Orleans, we'll also go for that, for an airstrip. And in Los Angeles, we'll go for an aerodrome, to give us the bomber as well. Oh, and in Casablanca we'll go for an aerodrome, and in Palembang of stables we get the T1 Cunningham, the M4 Sherman, and the Harley Davidson XA motorcycle. Okay. And I think we're done actually. Now it's the recruitment, but I believe we are already recruiting everywhere. We'll check. No, in Onaria we can go for some planes. And we are still rich. We have 36,200, so the United States is a very rich faction, which is very good for us. Let's go for the Grenadiers, they are best. They are the best out of those three. In Batavia, we can go for some new troops. Batavia, so that's over there. We need troops here, so we'll go for Corsairs, and we can go for, actually I want some artillery, so we'll go for a M7 Priest, we will go for M5 Howitzer and Stokes Mortar, we can also go for an anti-aircraft truck, and a M53, M55 artillery, and then Corsairs, and Harley Davidson motorcycle, and can go for a M4 Sherman, and more of the planes. Okay. In Palembang, we can go for some corsairs, and in Casablanca, we'll go for some corsairs. Reykjavik, we can go for some ships, actually. Go for the Chester. In Boston, you're still constructing ships, same in New York. In Washington, we'll go for the Corsairs. And in Panama, we'll go for the Chester frigate. And missed one area there in Denver. We'll go for the Grenadiers. And we're done, I believe. Okay, now we'll move the agents. Do we have a ship here? No, it's the British ship. Okay. So we had an arm here, moving towards land. We'll move them back there. Right, so MacArthur is in Hollandia with an army. And now we will check our agents. We'll move the spy over here, female spy. So the other factions used to move troops here, so we'll move over here. No one was visible in this area. Okay, we'll move the diplomat towards Chile, represented by Spain in this mod.
Yes, sire.
In my sub mod. Here we have Spain. Oh, the neutrals have taken over. We'll speak to Spain instead. And we will ask them for map information.
Left-click on an item.
Trade rights.
A balanced or very generous.
Yeah, that's historical anyway. So they have a large army here, I believe. Spanish army. Including anti-tanks. Anti-tank infantry. Really good now because they are many. And they have some Messerschmitts with unique skins. So they are the same fighter planes as the Germans. They also have the same dive bombers as the Germans, the Stukas. The difference is that these guys, the Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, they are unique for the Spanish, while the Stukas have the same skin as the Germans. Then they have some Panzer IVs, medium tanks, they have some Scout snipers, they're also good. They have some armored officer's car of the Spanish. Have riflemen, Stokes mortar, pack 40 German artillery, and Panzer I German artillery. The Germans and the Italians, they helped the Spanish during the Spanish Civil War in between 1936 and 1939, and Chile is represented by Spain, so they have the Spanish army pretty much. Also in real life, the Chilean army during World War II looked a lot like the Nazis and looked a lot like the Spanish do in this mod. Okay. They have the same helmets as the Germans but brown uniforms. Okay. We need to move the troops here to or the agent, I mean the diplomat. Fleet here. Let's move over to Turkey. The diplomat and speak to Turkey immediately. You'll get their map information as well. So I don't really want to restart this campaign. But I do a lot of stuff that I did during 2 weeks before starting this one. But you know, I want to play on the version with all the settlements if I can, like Paris and such. Much more fun to liberate Paris when it looks like Paris is a really cool city. And I want the new custom settlements and other new stuff, but I also want many of my changes, so moving to the other version would mean I need to redo some of my work that I have already finished on this version. But if I do not move there, we won't have the Italian cities or the French cities, among other stuff. Okay, let's get Turkey's map information now. So Turkey on the map. If you zoom in on the map, you can see that we have Spain and we have Turkey now. Turkey is a neutral faction.
Yes, my lord.
We can move immediately to Bulgaria. We'll do that. Get their map information.
Click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it.
A balanced or very got Bulgaria on the map. By the way, I plan on playing some of my other campaigns now and not just Hyrule. I was going to play one episode from a different campaign or a different game after each other and then return to the ones that I started when I played everyone else, but I really felt like playing Hyrule, so I ended up playing a lot of Hyrule and Warcraft. Okay, and not much of anything else. But I want to set into system to put into system to a balanced and very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted. To play play more than just one game. Okay. So you got the information of Romania too. They have three areas. Sire. You already had the Germans. We could use Hungary on the map. Even though we probably already have them. Speaking to others that had them, we'll see. Left click on an item in the proposal. Information. A balanced or very generous treaty. Okay, so we have Hungary. Now we obviously lacked Soviet Union. So we want the Soviet Union too. We can't reach him this time. So we have a fleet over here. We want to move back. We're blockaded by an Italian fleet, a huge Italian fleet probably, yeah. A lot of good ships like the Roma, the Giulio Cesare, so Rome, and Julius Caesar, with the names of the ships. Okay. Okay, so we're done with moving the agent in both South America and in Europe. Yeah, I really like my changes to South America. Anyway, so can now attack finally. We'll attack with this army because it can't do anything against planes and tanks. So we'll attack with this one. Okay, so your forces, Captain Dale. With 1,681 men, infantry, all of them, and Captain Henry with 2,193 men, including planes and tanks and such, but no artillery, and Captain Yoshisuke of the Japanese Empire with 343 men, including zero fighters and Rinatosu tanks and some cavalry. Okay, let's fight this battle on the battle map. We'll save the game first, of course. In case it crashes. So let's start the battle. Let's fight battle on the battle map. So I do plan on starting some new campaigns too in Rome Total War. Mods for Rome Total War. There are some new mods. Scans at Total War and some others that have received submods they want to play. And I need to continue the Avatar, the Last Airbender Total War campaign too, but there is a new version, unreleased currently, but should be released soon, which added improvements to the custom settlements, and I probably want to wait on that before starting or continuing the campaign. Restarting it, I mean. If I play on the old version, it would be obsolete soon anyway. It's better to wait on the new one. Then we have the Amazon Total War campaign. I need to fix some strat models that were bugged before continuing it. But yeah, I want to continue that one too. I didn't use this computer when I played there the last time. And it would be fun to play that mod as well, using the best possible graphics, but of course I can't use the nude version. We'll use the 13 plus version, the most stable version, the best version, but of course certain models are not as sexy. But it's the most stable version and also the only version you can play on YouTube without risking your channel. Okay, so we have some infantry. I won't send them in because they are gonna be killed easily by their planes. Let's move them back a bit in case the planes can fire at them. And place them in loose formation. Let's start the battle. I did a mistake. Fuck! I was supposed to select the AI control that army. We will have to exit. Sometimes I forget details like that. So I need to load again the game. I don't know how I missed that on clicking that button, but we will have to reload. Probably were thinking on other stuff and had my mind on other stuff and therefore missed out on that detail. Alright, let's check this. The scripts are on. Allow this army to be controlled by the AI. Yes, and let's fight the battle on the battle map. Only thing we have to fear is fear itself. Franklin D. Roosevelt, March 4, 1933. Inaugural address. Alright, let's start deployment. Now we need to redo this again. We will drop the RAM, by the way, we don't need it. So, loose formation with everyone, group them. And move them back. As far as we can. Good. Okay, start the battle and let our allied army attack the city. So they have some Siegfried walls here with bunkers protecting them. They will kill some of our troops as they move towards the city. These guns are gonna kill some of them. So the Japanese planes are defending. Some T1 Cunningham tanks moving towards the city. They managed to move in without being shot down by the bunkers. Thought they would lose something. Thought they would lose some of the tanks before reaching the city, but they didn't. The Japanese do have zeros in the air. So we'll see how this will go. For some reason, the rest of the army isn't moving. I don't know why. If that's the case, try to click attack one unit. Hope the allied army will start moving. If not, there is something wrong. Maybe they are using up. But they didn't have any artillery, I think. So I'm not sure why they are not moving. But they moved one of the tanks.
The Lord is with us today! We've captured the enemy's walls.
Let's stop this movement, it's suicide. Okay, and move back to this front. Ah, our planes have entered. The Corsairs are now in the sky here, inside of the wall, fighting their planes. Yeah, I think it's better with more numbers like this. Looks more epic. Let's see if we can defeat the Japanese. I believe we have the numerical advantage in the air. We have more Corsairs than they have zeros. The Corsairs are slightly better in my opinion. The zeros. Despite losing against the French planes. French planes were better than I thought.
Good tidings. The enemy general lies dead. We've sent the base.
Captain Yoshisuke of the Japanese Empire died. Right, then they have some tanks on the ground. They're now some tanks. because all the cities in this version looked like German cities. They didn't want any room to draw vanilla cities, and we only had the Germans done. Here we have the Japanese cavalry. Backpacks on their backs. Captured gateway. Alright, we don't need to read all of this. We lost it and then we recaptured it. Etc, etc. Okay. Disappointed that the American army is just standing outside, but maybe they are waiting for the troops to move. Here we have some American infantry, actually. Salt infantry. So we are sending in a few at a time. I don't know why they didn't send in everyone. Like I expected. Okay, so most of the army is just standing outside, waiting. We have now taken out most of their tanks. They have 91 cavalry. When I have total numerical advantage like this, I prefer to just let the AI control the attacking army and watch the AI fight. But if it's an even battle, sometimes I prefer doing it manually. they are taking that before. Most of the armies do that side. Cavalry are holding the center. Seems they have taken out some of our planes. All right. Plane battles take a little bit too long, maybe, but they're pretty cool. I've had it. Let's send in the infantry to the plaza. Take care of the cavalry. We can probably win by the time. Assault infantry and riflemen. Entire army here should be moving. Same time. Continue the battle. It's time to press. We took out the Japanese plane. Pretty sure. They might have one more plane or something. No, they have cavalry still. Changed. They took it again. We killed them.
This is a clear victory that goes to only men of great.
All right, clear victory. So they killed more than we did. Okay. Nice chap, no general, Field Marshal Lord Montgomery on Dwight the Eisenhower. Ah, nice chap, no general. Dominate, because otherwise they might revolt. In this mod, it has a big problem with revolts. Okay, let's merge the troops, and the army will continue. Here we have Thailand, a neutral faction. We managed to enter their territory, which is good. Keep our infantry in Kuala Lumpur, the capital of Malaya. Okay, we have unfortunately transgressed into Thailand, so they might attack us now. I didn't want war with Thailand. I want to attack the Japanese, but it seems we have the British, our ally here. And then we have Thailand, and we have the Japanese here holding Saigon. We would probably benefit using a fleet to transport our troops there. Problem is that we moved into Thailand with the army. We moved a fleet to our new port in Kuala Lumpur, and we can't do much else this time. guess we will have to click end turn. The Commonwealth of Nations have sent a diplomat to us in Casablanca. They try to bribe the area, I believe. Okay, rioting in Kuala Lumpur. Yeah, we have problems with revolts in this game. We will always exterminate just to try to prevent revolts. Because this is not a finished mod, so it has some problems that shouldn't be in the finished mod. Okay, diplomatic information. The following factions are now at war with each other. The Commonwealth of Nations and Bulgaria. The following factions have declared a ceasefire. The Bulgarian French Republic. Yeah. Candidate for adoption. We won't adopt anyone. Army will move into the fleet. Actually, they will move out of the fleet immediately because it's too dangerous to be in the fleet. We have so small a fleet, so they will board the next time and then move to Saigon so we can attack the Japanese there and liberate it. We want to liberate Southeastern Asia. But also, we want to retake the Philippines. They should belong to us. So we might actually want to go to the Philippines instead of Saigon. We'll see. I think we'll go to the Philippines. Okay, writing Kuala Lumpur. End of turn report. Okay, faction announcements. Construction report. We have a lot of airstrips and aerodromes. Okay, different locations, different cities. Recruitment report. We finally get our new ships. New Orleans, Iowa, and such, some artillery and other stuff. That's good. We need a big fleet. Fast. Our best ships. Here we have some really good ships. New Orleans and Iowa. We just need to combine them with other fleets. Here we have a bunch of Chesters, the most simple ship, with the exception of the troopers, of course. The most simple, like, battleship, the frigate. Okay, we will move these ships into this fleet too, so it will become more powerful. We should have more fleets. Some New Orleans and Iowa here, I believe. Yes, move them over there. Even more of them here. We can go no further this Okay, so our goal is to combine our fleet into one big fleet. In order to have a chance against the Japanese, we need only good ships. So I don't really want the Chesters in the fleet. But for now, we will add any ship that we have. Then we'll move out the Saki ships, then we can replace them with better stuff. Here we even have a New Mexico. Okay. All right. Another fleet over here. Side of Boston, the port of Boston, actually. If you move it down too. No reason to waste time. We want our fleet battles soon as possible. We have a British fleet, not the biggest one. We have some ships too, we can keep them in that port. We need this fleet to move the army we have here. We have a pretty big army, two generals, Billy Nelson and Dwight Eisenhower, and no general the heir of the faction. We have an army. So, this army is not that far away from the Germans. We want it to have go away, and we need more troops. So we could send it towards the American mainland. Okay, so we reached the port of Boston. How many units do we need in the army? We need to leave at least, we can leave 4 infantry units here. No, we leave Billy Nelson here. And 1 unit of riflemen. Okay, so we need exactly 7 units. Of course we will move the tank and the planes here too. That's 4 units, and then we have 2 assault riflemen and 1 here. So these are 7 units that we needed. I will just need them to move back to Reykjavik. We want them. Actually, they do not need to move back to Reykjavik. Or actually, they do. I want them to join forces there, because if we land in Germany or anywhere else, they might be attacked and they are not ready. They don't have a fully sized army yet. So we want to build up the troops, and then we send them to Casablanca. We'll try to send them back there. So we need to defend this area. We lost against the French, but we can try again. Win this time. We have peace currently, a truce. They are neutral, but we will try again. Okay, let's see here. We will move the diplomat. We still want to speak to the Soviet Union and to Finland, I believe. I don't believe the German front has changed much, but we can speak to the Germans again just to see if they have any new areas on the map. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove. So I want the latest map information. Then we move towards the Finns. Oh, seems the Finnish capital has fallen to the Soviet Union. Helsinki has fallen, but Finland also has an area over here. They might be defeated if we're unlucky. Finns. Okay, we can move further. Then we'll move over here. Tomorrow's journey plan. Ah, it's a white line. I believe Finland is still holding this area. It's very good. So the front is, they have lost their capital, but they still hold the Petrozavodsk area, taken from Soviet in earlier in the war. They had at the start of the campaign in 1942. They took it in 1941, I believe. Okay, so as far as I can see, the Germans are still holding Stalino. And they're holding areas over here, including this area, Smolensk. Alright, yeah, they seem to be holding areas. They are not holding Benghazi anymore. The British have taken Benghazi from the Germans. That's where Rommel started. Tunis is still held by Germany too. Okay, the British have taken the at least one area from Italy. Cardum. are about to take another two. Okay. Yeah. So we're done. Moving the diplomat. Remove the spy.
A pleasure, Your Highness. Happily, sire. Hi.
Oh, we have the Portuguese army here, the Brazilian army. Okay. They have scout snipers, general's bodyguard, then armored officer's car. Okay. Same bodyguard as the Spanish, Spain. So they have the scout snipers, they have hurricane planes, British planes with unique Portuguese skins. They have the M4 Shermans. And the tanks, so they have the same medium tanks as we have. They have the M580 Stuarts, light tanks from America. And they have anti-tanks, riflemen, Stokes Mortar, Grenadiers, Sextons, Wellingtons, Grenadiers. Yeah, I believe in my sub-mod I added a bunch of units to each faction that are not supposed to be in their factions in the official mod, because Dagovax wanted certain factions to not have tanks and certain factions to not have planes. Well, I wanted all of them to have tanks and planes if they had that historically. So the only one that do not have planes, I believe, is the I believe it's the India faction. They do not have planes, but they do have in the late game, they get British planes. But not in the beginning. So I think all have planes in this version, actually. Everyone has planes and everyone has tanks, because the stats are such that you can't defeat planes if you have infantry or tanks. You need actual planes to defeat planes. And that's why everyone needed planes. Not everyone has tanks, I believe. But most factions. Okay. So we have the Portuguese army, we'll call them the Brazilian army here, they represent Brazil here, and the Spanish army, they represented Chile in this area. I would say that I think the Brazilian one is better, because they have heavy bombers, but otherwise the Spanish one has better tanks. Okay, because they have these guys, the Wellingtons, heavy bombers, really good. Okay, so we are done with the movement of agents. Can't really do much else in this region. Lead diplomat outside of Chile, and spike and move anymore this time. Have no armies in Africa, except in Casablanca, where we are too weak to expand. Moved a diplomat in Europe, and we have moved some fleets. We can do the recruitment and construction, we'll do that now. We already moved the troops in Southeastern Asia or whatever, or East Southeastern Asia. And we will move towards the Philippines during the next turn. For now we can't do that, so we'll check the recruitment and construction. In Jacksonville, we'll go for the aerodrome. And in Dallas, we'll also go for an aerodrome. And same in Las Vegas, so we'll get the best planes. Heavy bombers in all areas. Fortunately, the United States do not have any better planes than the B-17 Boeing, or the B-17, whatever they are named. Let's see. Boeing B-17, yeah. Okay. Cavalry stables, let's go for that so we get some better tanks in Batavia and Kuala Lumpur. We need to prevent revolts. We could use something that improves the public bonus, so we'll go for this small perk. So they have a small perk, but they don't have the proper unit card for it. Okay. Because the Germans and all factions using the German culture have proper unit cards for them. Okay, we're done. Recruitment. I don't know if we have many areas where we can recruit. Maybe one or two. In Kuala Lumpur, we can go for a trooper ship. And I believe we are done. We will click and turn. The British are still trying to bribe Casablanca. The Japanese Empire wants a ceasefire. they do want a ceasefire. But I don't know. Do we want a ceasefire so they can conquer all of Asia? No. I think we will try to play this historically, so we do not want to ceasefire, sorry. We want the Philippines back. They've already taken the Philippines and forced our troops there to march the Death March. Okay. So of course we want that area back. We have some new troops. We have Corsairs, Grenadiers, Chester ships, M7 Priest, artillery. Grenadiers, etc., etc. War declared, the French Republic has declared war on Bulgaria. Strike complete, small perk in Hollandia. Action announcement and then report. Okay, so we will move the troops. We might have some new troops. New plane here. I don't care about that right now. The infantry. Move these troops into the ships. Then we'll obviously move immediately to the Philippines. Where they have an army. And then we'll move back to the ships. Because they are safe inside of the port. More safe at least. They have an army here. Including riflemen, grenadiers, Type 96 artillery, and also tanks, Stokes mortars. Okay, we have also some troops inside of Kuching. Okay, we will immediately, I believe, attack. We will besiege them, force them to attack us. Trick assault, we can attack immediately. Surprisingly, they do not have any defenses. It's a village. They have some zero planes there and some infantry. Okay, we could probably fight this battle too. Control the army manually, we'll fight the battle on the battle map, because it's more fun to do that. So we played slightly more than an hour now. I wanted to play an hour. So we'll finish this battle, move the agents, and do the construction and that, and then we finish the turn, and then click enter, and then we'll exit. Okay, start deployment. Army is now outside of this area, Kuching, held by the Japanese Empire. And we have some tanks and some planes in the army, some motorcycles. Alright, we'll group the troops. Our infantry should be one group. Makes sense. Loose formation. Blue Grenadiers could be one group on their own. They are much better than the other infantry. Same with the anti-tanks, they will be one group. The other infantry will be one. The motorcycles could be one group as well. They could be part of the ordinary infantry group. The tanks could be one group. And the planes could be one group. Alright, and lose formation with everyone. Okay, and the tanks, lose formation. And we're done. Let's start the battle. Ah, so they had a wall here. The improved wall with a much larger gate. A much better gate. I guess we will... no choice but to attack with the planes and the tanks. We will attack with the planes first. So we have no heavy bombers in this army anymore. We lost them, I believe.
We took the gate,
good. Okay. But they have a lot of planes. We want to take them out before sending in infantry. We'll probably send in the T1 Cunningham tanks. Let's move them towards the center. Davidson's. Send in all our vehicles, not the infantry. They're moving. Ah, but the Harley Davidson's are... Oh, the Japanese planes, they moved out of the city. We have total numerical advantage. We had one unit, we had four. Clearly see that we are dominating the sky. About catching. Tanks on the ground. Some of the planes we legion reach the plaza. The banner has been changed. We won the battle to Kuching from the Japanese Empire. Yeah, it was kind of fun to play in manually. Okay, so I made sure that the army would just stand outside doing nothing. If I had played on huge unit size with my sub mod, the lines of troops would have been so many that they wouldn't have been able to move in the city properly. So that's why if I clicked on the infantry to move into the city, they wouldn't do anything. So that's why I play on large. Okay. So that went well, but they have an army outside and they still have the other city that they took from us in the second episode. So we'll need to move there and take that city too. But before that we need to defeat the army. I believe they will attack us, so that's fine. We'll have to fight a defensive battle, I believe, against this army. Now we took Kuching. So they have this area too. Balikpapan they took from us. But I believe this army will attack us. Maybe we should actually move out and meet it. Could do that. Let's see here. We could... do they have... mostly infantry? Yeah, I like the idea of moving out and just defeating them. We'll do that. Save the game. Allow this army to be controlled by the AI, yes. For the battle on the battle map. So we have a total victory in this area. And have reconquered half of the Philippines. Start deployment. Infantry can be in loose formation, start the battle. Let's move the infantry back, they had planes. They had a lot of planes, they will easily kill them. They even had tanks. The Japanese are moving forward. They are firing at us as we are. Retreating. Yeah, we are too close to them. They are not listening when I click on them. Okay, let's just send a horn. Let's charge their troops. They will all die. Lost a unit of assault rifle. Okay. Our allies are already here. Their huge air force of Corsairs, 4 units, so we should be able to win. We have total numerical advantage in the air. General lies slain upon the battlefield. Should certainly win. Yeah, they will lose this area and this battle. Okay. I did decide to let the allies, the AI controlled allied army, because I thought it was very much in our favor. Battle. Heroic death, Captain Arthur. Okay. Reinforcements, Captain Miley. Miley. So in this game, I might actually need to focus on buildings that improve public order to prevent revolt in areas that I conquer. Some areas at least. Here they have a Type 96 artillery gun. They're only good at artillery unit. The cool gun. We have a few of them. Maxed out them too. We have 6, I believe, in a unit. Instead of 2. They still have an air force. They are retreating. Tanks are leaving the battlefield. Their Renault-Utzes are leaving. And their air force too. Alright, so they left. Yeah, it looks much better in the air. And you have many planes and many tanks on the ground. Looks better too. Of course, when you had maxed out the infantry, it looked better, but didn't work well. At least not in siege battles, as I said before. So they still have some troops. Some infantry. We are killing off here. We won the battle. Kill 78%, let's continue. Alright, so we crushed the Japanese outside of Kuching. Pronounce it. I was surprised that they want peace. But obviously, we do not want peace on their terms. Not in this early stage of the game. While I wouldn't have any problems with Japan conquering Asia, I believe that in real life the United States wouldn't allow that, so we need to stop them from doing that. They still like Japan more than the other nations in Asia. But anyway, we will stop them, like in history. Okay, the man of the hour. We'll get a general. A reward for the battle. Back into Kuching. Move these troops there too. Okay, so we got the general, family member Kenneth Murphy. Okay. And during the next time, we will obviously march. We could march immediately. We'll do that. Okay, so we have Isuruka Yamamoto here, a non-general. We didn't have much of an army. We will obviously attack. I'm a little worried that the other area will revolt. Okay, but we will attack here. Balance of power arm strength ratio 5-2 in our favor. Let's start the battle. We'll control it manually. We'll reconquer all of the Philippines in this episode. So now I know what I will name the episode. Finish the turn after this battle, and then we will save the game and exit and continue another time. Let's start the deployment. So this episode became a little bit longer than I had planned, so I wanted to do some stuff before stopping the gameplay. Okay, we will group the planes into one group. One group loose formation. The grenadiers and the anti-tanks could be one group. Because they are OP. That's assault infantry. We don't want them in the group. But we do want grenadiers in one group. Okay, and then the Harley Davidsons in one group in loose formation. Infantry riflemen or assault rifles in one group. The riflemen could be in the same group as the assault rifles. And then we have the tanks in one group. And the general's bodyguard could be in loose formation. Let's start the battle. So, this settlement didn't have any walls. Japanese took it. Their army previously. We'll send our tanks here. Let's pause the game so we can click on their shadows to attack. And we will also send, of course, our tanks. And I believe that's it. We'll send the tanks and the airplanes and nothing else. Oh, something is firing. They had a Type 96 artillery gun here, six of them. They had quite a powerful projectile, but they were taken out by airplanes. Easily we took out their crews. Now the tanks are entering T1 Cunningham's. The worst tank in our roster. And our planes have entered. Bodyguard, General's bodyguard, Yamamoto himself, Mr. Yamamoto. Okay, so we kill Yamamoto and retake Balikpapan from the Japanese Empire. I will probably not destroy Japan, but I will, maybe I will. I kind of want to invade the Japanese homeland. The problem is that the cities look like German cities, but still would be cool to just take everything. I don't know. We'll see. Can't drop an atomic bomb in this mod, so we need to take the area the conventional way. Leave our winning in the air. We had one unit, we had four. Even though our four units have been in battle previously, but we still outnumber them in the air. The land too. Their tanks might have been better quality, but we got help from the air to take them out, the Japanese tanks. Their jeeps. Almost all now. You can see they have only very few planes in the air still. They have lost 60%, they lost 3%. Alright, we won the battle. It wasn't MacArthur that retook the Philippines this time. Of course, after we have taken this area, we will move to that other area, Saigon. Take it. The Japanese. Banner has been changed, the plaza city. Alright, still have a plane here. Maybe somewhere else too. Yeah, they have some planes over here. Alright, let's fast forward. Enemy general fallen, so Yamamoto. He wasn't on a ship in this mod. Okay, so the battle is in our favor. Is running down, we'll win in 2 minutes, 6 seconds. All of and we won, took down the final Zero fighter. Good job, soldiers. Okay, so we killed 150, they killed 31. Battle statistics. Soldier, he's a bad politician, and as a politician, he's an equally bad soldier. Okay, Adolf Hitler on Churchill, May 1941. We reconquered Balikpapan from the Japanese Empire.
You commanded, sire. These lands are now yours.
Alright, very good. Good job, soldiers. We have conquered the Philippines. We only had two areas there. We have a port now here too. Very good. That means the ships can move again. Let's move them to the port here. And let's wait on another turn so we can move the fleet. The British have a huge fleet over here. So Papua New Guinea and the Philippines have been reconquered, and we've taken Kuala Lumpur from the Japanese Empire. The next goal is to take Saigon from the Japanese and hope that the Thailand faction won't attack. We don't necessarily want to war with them. In history, the Thailand faction was an ally of Japan against the British, but they were still neutral to the United States. They never had a war with the United States, despite being at war with the British and some others. I believe they didn't do a formal declaration of war. Okay, so we need to take Manila to their base over here, large town. We'll start with taking Saigon, I believe. Maybe we'll go first and take Manila, and then we'll take Saigon. Maybe we'll take Manila and then take Taiwan. After that, take the areas over here, Saigon, and the other areas they hold in China. We'll see. Let's check if we have any agents we can move. Yeah, we can move the spy here. We'll do that. See that Portugal or Brazil are still in control of Sao Paulo. The only Brazilian area on the map. We have some armored officer's car, fire 3000 Italian tanks, and aircraft trucks. And then they have their army, same that we already checked out, I believe. Pretty good army for them, including Sherman tanks and such. Can move the fleet again. We'll move these ships to the rest of the, we'll merge all the fleets that we can merge. We'll of course replace any shitty troops. Any troopers will be removed out in favor of the New Orleans here and the New Mexico and the New Orleans. Okay, so a one lone trooper there. What? We're supposed to move out there. I don't know what happened now. Anyway, let's move to this fleet. And yeah, we could move back. We have a pretty big fleet there. Only one ship here. New Mexico. Weird. I don't know why it wasn't added, but now it is. Very good. We have a full-sized fleet again. But it consists of a bunch of troopers too. We would like those troopers replaced with something better. We're not entirely happy with that fleet. We have this fleet too that we can move. We'll move it immediately. And move past the British fleet and hope they won't betray us. They can't. We managed to reach our shores in Reykjavik, Iceland, under United States supervision during World War II. Okay, we moved out the army under Dwight Eisenhower. We won't move them into the fleet this time. We can move these fleets here. Okay, so we have an army. It's obviously too weak, an army to fight the Germans. Look at it. It's mostly infantry. It has a M5 howitzer, Stoke mortars, and it has 4 units of Corsairs, just like the other army. And it has some tanks, 2 units of T1 Cunningham and 1 unit of M4 Sherman. That can be compared to the Germans having access to the... I believe they have access to Panzer IVs and Tigers and such. We can't fight the Germans this early in the war. We'll move this army to Casablanca and reinforce this area and try again to liberate Vichy French areas. We'll declare war on the Vichy French. Okay, we might attack the Germans in Tunisia, but not in Germany. They are too strong. Not only have they a million armies, but also probably better tanks than we have. While their planes are probably better than ours, or same quality. Okay, they do not have any jets in the beginning, I believe. They can only get jets from either from German cities or from Berlin. I don't know. I don't remember. I think it's from German cities, only the core German cities, like 5 cities or something. 3 cities, maybe. Okay, we will move this army to Africa, most likely, and aid there. Or we will move it to South America. We do not have any war there currently, so I don't know. We have a diplomat outside of Chile. We don't need to move it. We had a diplomat here too. We want to move to Finland. Petrosavodska, Russian area conquered by Finland. We will speak to the Finnish army over here. The Finnish army, by the way, in this submod has maxed out stats. At least their main army. Let's see, we will go for show me how, we will map information. They will formulate war, I believe, due to their the Finnish alliance with Germany, so we won't have trade rights with them. But now we can see their area, Petrozavodsk. They have some cool units, including T-34s they have taken from the Russians after victories. Have some Messerschmitt German planes that they got from Germany. Have some Hurricane British planes that they got from Britain during the Winter War, and they have some assault infantry. They have some Molotov throwers, and they have some U-88 German heavy bombers and fighters. They are like twin-engine multi-combat aircraft. And then we have the Panzer IVs of Germany, with Finnish skins, of course. And we have the Ski Troopers, really cool units with unique animations. Okay, so of course I like Finland, but unfortunately they are so weak in the campaign due to only having 2 areas that they would be attacked by everyone they border, like Germany and Soviet, and crushed. I mean, you can't defeat all of Germany and all of Soviet when they attack you at once. If you play 2.0, on the other hand, they are in a, I believe, forced alliance with Germany, but you still have to fight Soviet, and they still have a million armies they can throw at you. Okay, but they have cool units though, I have to say. Okay, so we've spoken to Finland, and now it's the Soviet Union that we want to speak to. Here we have a Soviet army, perfect. We'll speak to the army. And we are allied. We do not have them on the map, so we'll get that now. And now we got Soviet on the map. See that they have all of this. And then they also have areas in Asia. We got a bunch of areas here too. Okay, as for construction, check the buildings first. Okay, So in Hollandia, could go for something that will improve the public order. I want better public order, to be honest. We didn't have any such option here. Okay, then we'll go for stables. We can get tanks in Hollandia. And in Balikpapan, go for the small perks, we'll get public bonus 5%. Kuching, we'll also go for that. So I want public health bonus 5%. Okay. And we're back in Boston. Let's check the recruitment. Probably have somewhere we can recruit. So I've spoken to everyone in Europe pretty much, and everyone in Africa, and everyone in South America, and everyone in North America. So we only need Asia now. Saudi Arabia and Iran aren't in the mod. I believe Iran was conquered by the combined might of Britain and Soviet. So this area should probably be Soviet or Britain, and then Saudi Arabia, they were allied, they were an allied power, but they didn't join until the late war, I believe, so they were not kind of involved until like 1944 or 1945, and they were never really involved in the fighting. I believe they joined the war against Germany in the late war, when Germany had pretty much lost. Okay, and then we have Asia, where we have China, we have Thailand. We have two Chinese factions, the Republic of China and the People's Republic of China. Then we have Thailand. We need to speak to them, and we need to speak to India. And besides that, I believe we have a bunch of Japanese areas there too. We haven't spoken to the Japanese. We might need to send a diplomat to the Japanese. We could have taken that opportunity when they sent a diplomat to us. I forgot. We could have used the total diplomacy there. I made a mistake. Okay. So we were busy doing the unit recruitment. We will go back to doing that. They want to do that and then click end turn. So we have a fleet and we have an army in Reykjavik. The army will be sent. I believe we will send the army to Africa. And then we will send the fleet towards the Japanese, I believe. Is they needed there? The fleet has a beef with the Japanese, of course. Okay, let's see here in Kuala Lumpur, we go for some troopers. In Casablanca, go for Iowa, I think. That's the best trip, so we'll go for it. And we're done. Okay, let's end the turn. Game may have crashed or locked itself up, then I will have to restart it. It will not happen again, I'm pretty sure. I think it's game locked. We'll need to restart it and such. Okay, but I will do that the next time. So we'll see you in the next episode. Bye.